Schmitz. I'm a senior instructor here at Esri Training Services, and today I want to talk about how we can use the traverse tool to create new COGO features, actually a closed traverse, in a COGO-enabled feature class. COGO stands for coordinate geometry. It's basically a method for constructing features using surveyed bearings, distances, and angles. The key is that the dimensions that you enter to create the features are retained in the attribute table of the COGO-enabled feature class so that you have a record of how the feature was constructed. Just as a side note here, this workflow is performed on a simple geodatabase line feature class, not on a parcel fabric. It's different from the workflow that you would use to create a new parcel in a parcel fabric. So let's take a look at the COGO lines layer here. It's been created as a simple line layer, and then I have run the enable COGO geoprocessing tool on it to create these specific attribute fields in the table that will hold the COGO dimensions. Also, I made sure that the coordinate system of this layer matches the coordinate system of the map. You see, if we compare the two, they are both in NAD 83 state plane, Kansas North. Another setting to check are the project units. So in the project options, we can set our distance units. And in our case, that has to be US feet because state plane uses US feet. And our area units have been set to square feet as well. All right, now let's open the traverse tool. It's accessible from the gallery on the edit tab, or you can open it from the modify features pane directly. So what we will do is COGOing in a conservation area just adjacent north to these parcels. And notice also the traverse tool honors the ground to grid correction that has been set for this map. So I'm setting my start point. I'm snapping to the lot corner. Absolute XY would also work. And you see for the directions, we're using quadrant bearings. Quadrant bearings is a distance system that uses four different quadrants to enter the directions. So a quadrant bearing is an angle between 0 and 90 degrees entered as the degrees, minutes, seconds, indicating which quadrangle we're using. And don't worry, we can use shortcuts here to do that. So let's say from the starting point, I wanted to go 45 degrees, 45 minutes and 45 seconds into the first northeast quadrangle. I would enter 45 minus 45 minus 45 and then minus 1 for the first quadrangle. And then perhaps a distance of 100 feet, press enter, and there is our next course, our first course. Now, the nice thing about the traverse tool is that it assumes tangency. My next course will be a curve, a tangent curve tangent to this first segment. Actually, before I enter the curve, let me change the first segment. If I wanted to go straight north, I would enter 00 minus 00 minus 00 minus 1 for the first quadrangle. Enter again to enter the distance. And then we press enter to accept this default exit tangent, exit direction. Now, since this is a curve, the distance can be zeroed out. And instead, we're entering a curve radius and a curve length. This curve length could be entered as arc length, chord direction, and you will see we can override this also with a delta angle. We will do that in just a moment. But for now, you see a 50 feet radius will actually give us a right curve. If we wanted to go to the left, we would enter minus 50. And to override the arc length, say I wanted to go 180 degrees, D for degrees, enter, I would get a delta angle of 180 degrees. I want to go to the right, accept this, and my last course again is going to be tangent to the previous curve, so we accept the exit direction and enter a distance. Now, let me show you another trick. If I wanted to go 90 degrees to the left or to the right, I could simply enter a minus or a plus for the direction. So I want to go to the right 90 degrees perpendicular to this previous course. I enter plus and just press enter, and there we go. There is my closed traverse. We can finish this sketch. You see, we have a perfect misclosed distance, a high accuracy. But let's introduce a little mistake here. Let's see what happens if we enter for our last course, perhaps inadvertently, 99.95. Okay, so the misclosed distance tells us the discrepancy and it calculates a misclose ratio. Say we don't notice this mistake for now, we save our edits, close the traverse tool, but the next day we come back and see, okay, this is something that we need to fix. How can we pull these courses back into the traverse tool? Well, we can trace the lines that we want to edit and pull them back into the traverse tool, fix our mistake, save our edits, and we're done. All right, so I hope this was helpful. There is a lot of documentation about the traverse tool. I would recommend you start with a help topic, create a traverse. In the ArcGIS desktop help, it talks about the different kinds of traverses, how to enable COGO. Then there's a really good help topic about setting traverse units. And to enter a traverse, we have a help topic that gives you a lot of step-by-step instructions, how exactly to enter the courses for straight and curved traverses. All right, thank you for listening and see you next time.